Hey guys, welcome back. So if you watched the last two videos about my solar power station, they were kind of long and I did put the schematic at the end of the video, but in case you missed it, I'm going to post it right here in this video. So this video is the schematic only, and you can also find a link to the schematic in the description below, and that will be linked to my website. So enjoy. All right, so looking at the schematic, there are three main sections. We have on the very left, we have the legend. It shows a few of the components with their pinouts. We've got the 12-volt automotive relay with its pinout. So you can identify that on the schematic. The switch with its pinouts, and also the buck converters. There is a 20-amp and a 40-amp buck converter. So one is larger. These components are all for the DC side. So again, if you're not going to build a DC side, then it's completely optional. You don't need it. So the next section is the AC side. And if you want to just build the basic system, all you need to do is worry about the stuff in the AC side. You don't even need this 20 amp inline fuse. And I think you want everything else except shunt is optional. I think the shunt is an awesome device to have. So I would call it a critical device, but you don't need that either. But everything else you should have. So going to the DC side, I want to mention a few things. First of all, I want to mention, remember the blob? We talked about the blob earlier. And what that is this B1 and B2 at the upper right, these the positive and negative junction blocks, distribution blocks. What that is, if you look at the 20 amp buck converter output, it's basically these yellow lines, the B1 lines, B1, B1, and B1. It goes to the switch, and it goes to the relays, and it goes also over to the power LED for the positive side. And for the negative line, you have B2s, the B2 and B2, and also another, where's the other B2? Over here. So you got the LED on the switches, you got the negative on the power LED, and you got the negative on the fuse box, and you got the negative on the relays. So when I built the system, I didn't have these distribution blocks, so I just kind of ended up blobbing everything together. That's why you ended up with a blob. So yeah, I would definitely recommend installing these distribution blocks on the back of the board, so that way you have a nice connecting point for all your for these junctions for the 12-volt circuit. And the last thing I want to mention for the DC side is these the USB panel outlets. You can see up here that it's a modified circuit. So when you purchase the thing, the switch, the built-in switch, controls power to both the car adapter outlet and the USB outlet. So I didn't want to do that. I wanted to have separate circuits. I wanted the car adapter on one circuit and I wanted the USB outlet on another circuit. So the switch on this diagram, the switch only controls power to the car outlet, and that's on a 15 amp circuit. And the USB outlets, if you look really close, there's actually a little button. That little button turns on and off the power for the USB outlet. So there's no point to having a switch to something you can turn off individually anyway. So, and these run on a 10 amp circuit. You don't even need that. You can run these on a 5 amp circuit. All you need is 3 amps for a USB outlet. And yeah, so just note that this is a modified circuit. You don't have to do it this way. You can just wire these panels as they come when you buy them to the fuse box. Yeah, that's about it. You could also, alternatively, I mean, I wouldn't really recommend it, but you can use the fuse box. The negative fuse box bus bar is essentially a bus bar. They're all connected together. This is B2A. So B2A, you can connect all the B2s optionally to the fuse box bus bar negative side. But then you're kind of wasting that bus bar connections for other circuits that you can potentially add to your fuse block. So it's probably best just to go in with these terminal distribution terminal blocks, the B1 and B2. And that's how I would do it. So I'll eventually put a schematic on my website with the B1 and B2 blocks, and it'll be rewired for that.